ticket to the Final Four is up for grabs in tonight's Elite Eight matchup between the UCLA Bruins and the Kentucky Wildcats.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Wildcats know this isn't going to be an easy one. What's the key for them tonight, Dick?
Hey, the keys for them tonight are simple. First, pound the ball down low for some easy baskets. It'll be a bonus if you can get their big man in foul trouble. Second of all, be strong with the ball. Turnovers can be the story here tonight, so protect that basketball. Thirdly, don't get away from what got you here on defense. Don't try and do too much defensively.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. From way outside. Well, Dick, that didn't take very long.
I tell you, they're quick out of the gate, baby.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Tries for two, and off the mark. Both teams are looking to get something going here. He makes a nice shot fake, and he'll kick it back outside. Defense giving some room.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, it's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
They look to get it to the inside. Looking for contact.
Got to make that, baby. Have that wide open angle and a chance to lay it on the glass for an easy deuce.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
For the bucket. Doesn't go. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Looking for a good shot. Puts up the tray. Way off target. It in. Marshall handles the pass for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Shepard is emotionally fired up.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad. Trying to go inside.
The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
Goes up for two. Not a whole lot of luck getting the baskets to fall lately, Dick.
They definitely aren't getting the bounces right now.
Side jumper. He can't get the bucket to fall. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Tries for two.
And the bricks just keep on coming, baby.
I have to start looking for some easier baskets here, Dick. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. The Bruins will step to the line for the first time. Makes it. Trying to feed inside. Good job defensively. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
That's an 8-0 run.
The shooting guard receives the ball. On the dribble, gives it up from left of the circle. Oh, yes. Had a momentary look from three-point land.
It's not uncommon to have a few high-risers on your team these days. The game has definitely changed in that regard.
Working it around the perimeter. Jump hook from the low post.
Which I didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
I think they're trying to make a statement. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
From left of the circle.
Man, he lured the defender to the screen, giving him time to shoot the sweet J.
Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really...
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Fires away. Great shot. Him first, Dick, and it works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously, but they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
Takes the pass in the paint. Looking for the foul.
STOP. This place will be off the charts if they can get a stop here, Brad.
They move it into the front court. And he'll kick it back outside. Puts up the jumper. Can't connect. Shepherd handles the feed. On the low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
Gets his first. Both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Oh, big time screen set on the defender. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
Tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
High post flashes. They're working around the perimeter. He lets it go. They can't stop this guy, Dick.
Want to give him a try, Brian?
If only my knees weren't aching. Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
Rice receives the pass.
Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior.
Things are going well, and it's going well for the school mascot, too.
I tell you, I love those mascots. They put so much enthusiasm and energy into it.
Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
He puts in another score.
He can see the light, Brad, and it's hanging right over the goal.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
Count that as a personal foul. Shoots from the top of the key. He's doing a terrible job of distributing the ball.
They may have to pull him out and let somebody else out there. Let him think about it for a while.
At the foul line. Hits the first. Misses the second shot. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He's got to get rid of it. Puts it up, looking for contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score.
Look at that spacing.
For two. Up, easy one. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? High post flashes for the opportunity. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to go.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball with his deck. Where's he going? Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Now the high screen. He shoots from the angle. Off the rim and no good. On the outside, gave it up. He fouled him. This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat.
Terrell goes to the line for the first time. Free throw is good.
Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Not this time. At the half, the Bruins trailing by two. Nick, we've got a close one here tonight, my friend. Give us your highlight of the night so far.
I picked the kind of highlight that only a coach can love, Brad. His team working the ball down low to their big man for the inside basket.
We're about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's go down and see how this one unfolds. Kentucky did a masterful job of grabbing the boards in the first half, Mr. Vitale.
Wow, I'll tell you, Brad, these guys are so well coached. The coaching staff preaches the importance of winning the rebound battle. And then they went out there and they just did that.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. He up fakes. That spin move is not going to work against the defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Very soft defensively, no pressure on the basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. He gets the rejection. And the ball goes out of bounds. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
Dribble, gives it up, puts it on the floor, and up and under.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake and good footwork, keeping his pivot foot down.
On the inside, number 54 fakes the shot and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
On the outside, he shoots from downtown. Perfectly designed, perfectly executed, easy basket. Intercepted. And the ball goes out of play. Post flashes for the ball handler. Bridges receives the pass. Got it! Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays it where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of the post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position.
It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's obviously carrying his team, Brad. His teammates need to follow his lead and join in on the action.
Gave it up. For the bucket. Perfectly executed.
Up the other way, get a layup.
Trying to draw the foul. He gets the bucket to fall. The Wildcats are down by four. Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step, very slow.
Picks off the lazy pass. Pushes it. The dribble, gives it up. He goes for three. He couldn't get it to fall. The point guard takes the pass. He intercepts it. Gave it up. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position, spreading his body and getting the ball.
Cue up the replay, fellas. Inside.
The center handles the pass from right in the circle. fake. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Got a nice screen. And a momentary look from 3-point land. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Tries to get the D to bite.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Fakes it. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
He's mocking the crowd. Now, that's throwing salt on the wound. The fans are definitely going to be annoyed with him.
You've got that right, Brad.
Moving it around the perimeter. And working around the arc. With the fake. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
On the dribble, gives it up. Takes away the pass. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us here.
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
All right, thanks, Erin. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Great defense. The point guard gets the pass. Tries for two. Basket falls despite the contact. Terrell handles the feed. There they come with a double team to stop it. Off the rim and no good. Picked out of the air. The point guard gets the ball. Puts it up. Dickey simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up. He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Copeland receives the ball. Tries to draw the charge, and even he has to smile about this one.
I tell you, kidding me, that's one of the great acting jobs of all time. Get him an Oscar.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. There's a double team waiting there. And he'll kick it back outside. The center takes the feed. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Working around the perimeter. Gave it up. Takes the pass in the paint. Was that beautiful or what? two. Two with a lay-in. Timeout's been called. So let's check in with Aaron.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Thanks, Aaron.
Sometimes timeouts can take teams right out of their rhythm, Brad. Let's see what happens here.
It's a three-point deficit.
And that can change in a matter of seconds, baby. Hold on.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The small forward with the ball. He shoots from long range. Rims out. Working it around the perimeter. Fakes the shot. Defender knocked the ball loose, but the offense got it back. He nails the shot. Timeout. Both teams will get a breather here. We'll get a chance to talk things over.
Time, Brad.
Oh, it certainly can, Dick. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline. Better foul, quick.
Shot clock is dead. On the outside. That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick?
Now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to be able to get to that winner's circle.
Trying to hang on here. Well, Dick, what's the front court production looking like to you?
Well, you know, Brad, your bigs really can influence how your teams play. Rebound, blocking shots, ultimate shots are all very important skills that your big players should possess.
Well, Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for them right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
Sometimes a stat that gets lost, Dick, turnovers, and that can kill you in a ball game.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team's performance. If you give teams easy baskets, you got no shot to win.
The clock again.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock. If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
Goes up for two. Off the rim and no good. And the clock stopped with a foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
He goes to the line. Just like in practice. Misses the second shot.
They really need a score here to turn this into a one-possession game.
Here after the timeout. That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
He's got to pass those off, Dick.
He doesn't trust his teammates, Brad.
Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, I tell you, won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
UCLA wins and reaches the end of the road. These are the last road games of the season.
Hey, two wins are all they need, Mr. Nestler. And it's all they're thinking about as his team advances to the magical Final Four.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler saying so long.